I probably don't call myself a geodesist because I've wandered back and forth in the realm between studying crustal deformation and seismology. And if I say geodesist, normally no one knows what that is. So I normally say seismologist or geophysicist. But I could consider myself a geodesist in the sense that the area of geodesy has been interesting to me actually since long before I started doing it professionally.
So the question is, do I call myself a geodesist? And I think that is a really hard question to answer. People always ask me what I do, and I never have a good answer, even though I know that question is coming. I guess I would call myself a geodesist in some ways, but there's a level of kind of meticulous quantification inherent in geodesy that I don't think I'm very good at. So I more think of myself maybe as a geodynamicist or just a slinger of wild stories.
Well, I certainly do call myself a geodesist. When I was doing my PhD, I called myself a physicist. But I call myself a geodesist because I strongly affiliate with the geodesy community. And it's a fantastic community. It's international. The only way geodesy works is if everybody's sharing data around the world. You can't do anything on your own. So it just means naturally it's a great community. So to call myself anything but a geodesist wouldn't make any sense at all.
So I don't call myself a geodesist. Geodesy is my favorite tool of observation, but it's just one of the tools that as a really geologist who uses geological and geophysical tools to better understand the Earth can use to improve our understanding of the earthquake cycle and earth rheology, active tectonics. So geodesy is great, but I'm not a geodesist.
I do not call myself a geodesist. I call myself a geophysicist because I don't calculate the Earth's shape or the Earth's motion. I use those results to infer things about what's going on inside the Earth.
I call myself a geophysicist.
And why?
Because I use lots of different data types now to study crustal deformation processes and help others to study analyze measurements that have been made by a suite of instruments, not just GPS.
What do I call myself? It's always interesting when we have people come and visit our department, and you know they come and visit each of the faculty, and they say, "Well, what do you call yourself?" And I guess it depends on the day. If I'm working on one of our volcanism projects, I'll call myself a volcanologist or volcano geodesist. When I'm working on my plate boundary zone deformation work, I call myself a tectonic geodesist or geophysicist. So I think it depends, but I'm not a true geodesist. I'm really a geoscientist, geophysicist who uses geodetic methods to really understand Earth processes.
I do sometimes call myself a geodesist. It depends on the context. Sometimes I call myself a geodesist, sometimes I call myself a geophysicist because most people don't really know what geodesy is. So it depends on whether I want to explain what geodesy is. And then other times I refer to myself more as a volcanologist because a lot of the geodetic work I've done has been related to studying physical processes at volcanoes.
I call myself a geodesist when it's convenient. I call myself a geophysicist when it's convenient. Perhaps you could say I'm an observational Earth mechanician. So I am interested in how the Earth deforms, the physical processes, the mechanics, the material properties, what it tells us about the evolution of the Earth. So we're interested in this from a physics perspective, but we need to measure it and we need to observe it. And you know, the space of models that we can come up with is very large, and so really I view much of our obligation or our efforts is to try to restrict the space of models, to be able to reject models in some sense with the right kinds of observations. Now, of course, geodesy is a science in itself. It's a metrology, it's a study of measuring things. And there's a lot of science to be done just in how do we measure things better. How do we understand what it is we measure when we go out with a radar, a laser, or a GPS, or whatever. And so sometimes you spend a lot of effort trying to do the geodetic science, and sometimes it's more the earth mechanics, and it just depends on the day of the week.
I do call myself a geodesist. Unlike a lot of people that just use geodesy to get time series and coordinate time series and vectors, I worry about things like the reference frame, how air sources affect my velocities, time correlated noise, and those are the things that real geodesists have to worry about when you're trying to interpret your data.
I don't call myself a geodesist, I call myself a geophysicist that use geodetic measurements and actively pursue geodetic measurements, because the science of geodesy is the people who do that, they learn how to do very precise measurement, and they care about the uncertainties and not the application. I'm actually doing application. I use the geodetic measurement, apply them to different geological, hydrological problems, and that's why I call myself a geophysicist.